What's good, ladies and gentlemen? I'm your host, Mike, back here with another episode of the Truth to Power Show. Today is a beautiful Sunday evening. Beautiful because tomorrow's my weekend. I work a terrible, terrible schedule. I'm about to rant on this shit, actually, because my schedule is tearing my relationships with my family, friends and family apart. Because everybody in my family, like everybody in my friends, everybody around me assumes that I just don't go to their shit because I hate them or I don't really give a damn or I'm a selfish person. When in reality, I'm just working for the man, unfortunately. The man got me under his thumb. Y'all think I want to be? Now, granted, in the summertime, I do work in a nice air-conditioned building. So in the summertime, I'm like, shit, I'm saving AC. But do y'all think I prefer to be at a damn... I'm not about to put where I work at. But anyways, I definitely do not want to be at work. And I would rather be out with my friends and family doing whatever, whoever's birthday or baby shower or whatever, so forth. But I miss out on a lot of events because of my terrible ass schedule. But my terrible ass schedule also allows me to do things like this, which is be on this podcast, record this, talk a lot of shit because, yeah, for whatever reason. But anyways, you gotta take the good with the bad. God bless. Today is January 20th, 2019, by the way. Today's gonna be a lot looser episode, mainly for the reason because I wanna get my personality out there. I wanna toss some shit, joke. A lot of times people know me as a lot looser, more fun episodes. So let's get into it. Something that's really getting on my fucking nerves is Derrick Jaxn. Fellas, if you don't know who that is, I'm not going to say ladies if you don't know who that is, because all y'all females know who the fuck Derrick Jaxn is. That nigga be telling y'all straight bullshit. But that's what women love to hear in 2019. Let's be honest. I'm going to keep it real. I'm about to keep it 3,000% on this show. Fuck it. All shit is off. All the reins is off. I'm keeping it 1,000. Y'all kind of want to hear that bullshit, because let me give you an example. Derrick Jaxn has a video on like 7 reasons or some shit like that why you should date, why only a real man would date a single mother. And I'm like, bro, I get it. Shout out to single mothers, fam. Single mothers have to do work. They gotta do both parents' jobs, unfortunately. Let me not say both parents' jobs, because she can only do one job. She's just working double time. But essentially, that shit is hard work, and I want to shout out and salute the single mothers out there. My father passed at age 15. My mom raised my sister by herself up until the age of 7. To the same shit till now. She grown. Shout out to her. She held us down. She did the best that she could. Now, with that being said, it is very disingenuous for him to go on there and make it seem like dating a single mom is like something that you should be trying to fight to get at, or something that you should be working at trying to prove yourself to do. Bro, that in itself is hard work. That in itself comes with a lot of drama. First of all, let me be honest, bro. If a woman has a child by a man, unfortunately, there is a high likelihood that he can get that thing whenever he wants. I'm talking about all he got to do is say, look, I'm ready to get my family back. I'm tired of hitting these. I was in these streets hard. I was hitting these streets ham, doing who all knows what. And I just want to come back and make my family right. And your ass is out the door, potentially. Or she might not even potentially. She might just even redshirt that nigga and try to see like, oh, well, let me see if he's really going to play good. I'm going to give him some. Meanwhile, this nigga's dipping in everything out there in the world. And y'all niggas both dipping in the same. But it's just most likely mess. Now, are there great single mothers out there? I'm sure. And if you're listening to this, let's just assume that you are the great single mother. Just assume that I'm not talking about you at all. I don't care what your situation is. You can have multiple kids, multiple baby daddies, and no real thing to offer a man. But look, we're gonna still say that this is not about you. Anyways, yeah, bro, that shit is hard ass work. Like, when it comes to, first of all, the drama of the previous man, this man had a child with them. Like, I'll be honest with you, fam, I have a 2-year-old child. When you have a child with someone, when you go through pregnancy, that shit in itself is a bonding experience. That's like something, that's a different experience, bro. Like, you guys are really in it together, bringing your life into the world. That's a, you know, you can't just, I mean, I get it, there's pain and all kind of stuff like that, but essentially, look, a lot of y'all dudes is one homie trying to fix his family away from y'all being out on your door and spending a lot of money and a lot of time for no damn reason. So that's one thing that I have an issue with. I'm like, bro, I as a person who dated, you know, I've dated single mothers in my past, and not, and these were great women, very fine women. I'm on my Trump real quick. Very fine women indeed. But, and I'm gonna say, but, you know, that, like, you know, when you were, especially when you're a young dude, like, last time I was single, I was 20 years old. Bro, the last thing I was trying to hear, the last thing I was trying to hear about was some, I'm like trying to schedule a date, trying to, you know, trying to get sex dates around the child. Like, that's another thing, bro, that they will not talk about. That was a serious issue for me. I'm here now. I'm not trying to talk. I'm here now. You talking about your kid, and I'm right here now today. I'm in your area. I've got off work early. Ain't none of that. Spontaneousness, that's gone. Fan, that is, for the most part, that's gone. If she's a good mother, let me say that. You can't be out here, you know, getting it in, freaking all the time. You got kids all over. Like, that's not realistic. And I get it. You know, some men, they might, you know, shout out to you, she's a great woman, play the role. But to make it seem like it's like something that you should seek or something that's just like, bro, honestly, I feel like, you know, shit, let me come in the situation and get some extra credit. Like, bro, I'm coming in kind of taking off from the last man save game. Let's be honest, fam. I want to know what the intro is like. What was the first level like? Shit. I didn't want to start at necessarily level 3. I didn't even get none of the basics in. I didn't get to do the tutorial. I didn't get to do the jump shots. I didn't get shit. I just started off level 3. Fight. And I don't really want to get too much on the single mother shit, but it's just this Derrick Jaxn pandering shit is getting on my nerves. It's not necessarily single mothers themselves. It's just the shit that he panders to. This man literally will say nothing is a woman's fault. Like, that is a problem. And a lot of you niggas is getting into this shit too, this super feminist, super simp shit. And I honestly don't even understand why y'all get into that shit, because y'all honestly are doing that shit to pander and get females. And they not fucking with you anyway. Bro, let's be honest. Them chicks do not like niggas like you, bro. You the niggas from high school that was playing the role. You the nigga in high school that would open the door, you know? You need the Moses. You need somebody to lead, to start, to, you know, blaze the trail. And then you got somebody to close it. You got somebody to come in. And that's what always happens to y'all simps, y'all male feminists. And you know what's funny too? I noticed a trend. Male feminists are either moist, single, or both. I don't know what, like, fam. I'm going to say I'm 98% hitting on this. And I know it's, and look, like I said, if it don't fly, let it apply. Or what did it say? If it don't apply, let it fly. Yeah, you're the 2%. Everybody listen to this. You're the 2%. Just think of it that way. But yeah, it's like, bro, all you doing is, you the niggas that be taking her on dates, you the nigga that wake her up in the morning, hey, honey, how you having a good day? I left somebody, all that, I was thinking about you today. All this nice shit, all this sweet shit, you sending flowers to the job, you sending meals and all this extra stuff, and at the end of the day, you taking her out to eat, all this stuff, at the end of the day, Tyrone hit her at the end of the night and be like, look, make sure you bring leftovers. Because after we get done, I'm going to be hungry. I'm going to be parched. So if you can bring something to drink as well, some Hennessy, all that shit, bro. That's what's really happening. And look, I'm not saying this from a perspective of like I'm the king, master, gang, all this stuff. I'm saying because I was that dude, bro. I was the same person who thought playing that role was going to be successful. And I know a lot of y'all going to say like, y'all going to virtue signal. I'm like, no, it's about women and women's rights and all that other shit. Nigga, you lie. Because most of y'all niggas are creeps too. That's another thing, like that Terrain nigga. That nigga, oh, yeah, guys, we need to be in camp. Any dude that be on that super male feminist shit, I be looking at them super side eye and super suspect, because them be the number one creeps. They be the number one dudes in the chicks with in the basement and all that stuff. They be trying to play the good guy role, because a regular masculine just heterosexual, non-creep man, you're not doing extra shit. You don't have to go way above and beyond to prove that you are a regular human being. You're not going to rape a woman when you're in the room with her. Like, that's not realistic, bro. Like, a regular person does not have to go that far to show a woman, like, hey, I need you to be comfortable. Like, no, a woman should feel naturally comfortable around a masculine man and feel protected and all that great shit that comes with that. But instead, a lot of y'all get on the simp shit and y'all think that that's going to work. And instead, ultimately, Tyrone is still gonna get the draws. I heard whoever the nigga is that she really wanna fuck with. And a lot of these black feminists too, by the way, if you're a male feminist, more than likely the woman that you're trying to get is a black feminist, let's be honest, because a typical black woman sees that shit and be like, what? Like, I don't know, maybe it's just the woman in my family, but the women in my family is alpha, so they need an alpha themselves. They can't have nothing left. But they got this, like, weird-ass campaign to make dudes soft. Bro, I know y'all see that Gillette commercial. Fam, Gillette is wilding right now. Bro, Gillette had a commercial, and let me break down some of the things that I remember off the top of my head in the commercial. So the things I had issue with, and like one of the things was this dude, and maybe I gotta watch it 14,000 more times, but it was the scene where the woman walked past, and my boy looks like he's about to, like, you know, he's pulling out this chop, he's about to go put his bid in, he's about to see what's up, you know, shoot a shot. And oh boy, the black dude with the front, he grabbed him like, yo, whoa, 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 bro. Like, what are you doing? Like, you're gonna go approach a woman on the street? Like, you're just gonna go talk to her? She didn't ask you to talk. You're just unsolicited. Like, you're like, bro, where are we at right now, fam? I understand. Let's draw the line between harassment and like regular human interaction, bro. Like, it's weird for a person to approach a person online. Like, I have to go through the firewall of sending you a friend request, then if you approve it, then go through that, like, bro, or like approving your DM. Like, what are we getting to in the point where having actual interaction between two people is a strange thing, like, or looked down upon or frowned upon? Like, again, let's differentiate between men doing extra stuff, because yeah, there are those examples of dudes catcalling, being extra and all that kind of thirsty stuff like that. Yes, like, let's, like, we gotta differentiate and not, you know, show a video of a man just trying to approach a woman, and, you know, maybe he has some exuberance, he was probably excited, but bro, he's trying to put his bid in, he saw something that he liked and he wanted to talk to her. And like, and another thing that another scene I had an issue with was there were two boys wrestling, and all the men, all the fathers are sitting there watching them wrestle, saying, boys will just be boys, boys will just be boys. And eventually one father was brave enough to stop them. I'm like, bro, first of all, this was Mortal Kombat. Like, there's a point where, like, you know, you and your cousins are fighting, and maybe your uncles or whoever, cousins, they might even, like, you can't, you know, instigate it or whatever. But once it gets to a certain point, every human being is going to be like, okay, you guys cut it out. There's a point, there's a line where we men understand. We do need that, you know, we got to get that testosterone. We have to test the metal. But there's a point, there's a fine line where then the adult masculine man will say, hey, that's too far. But it seems like people don't want to have anything right now. Like, they don't want to even start the line. They don't want, everything is about this soft culture. Like, where are we really trying to go? Is this what we're trying to protect our women with? Is this what we want to protect our children with? Because that's the other narrative that's popular right now in the community, is protection. So how are we supposed to protect our women, our children, and every nigga soft? Nobody know how to wrestle. Nobody know how to fight. Nobody's ever been in a fight. Nobody know what happens when the bad guys show up. Because guess what? The bad guys know how to fight. The bad guys know how to shoot. They showing up with guns, because that's the other thing that a lot of Negroes like to talk about. Gun control. It's been another shooting, and we need more gun control. Even though it's the same people shooting every time that don't look like you. But you need to be, for some reason, they need to take your guns away. And that's going to solve the problem. It's never you or nobody that look like people you hang out with. Or let me just be honest and say anybody of color. But for some reason, every time a mass shooting happens, we talk about gun control. So let me get this straight. Hold on. Hold up. Give me a second while I fit my tinfoil hat on real quick. Because we just walked into the conspiracy zone. You mean to tell me that they're pushing this agenda to effeminize men, make men super soft. We keep hearing this conversation about gun control. Okay. Gun control, taking away guns, taking away the way to protect ourselves. And the men who are the protectors by the day are losing their power. The testosterone, we know they're so... Okay, out of the conspiracy zone, we're back into regular life now. Everything is good. We're sheep. We're going to ignore everything. Like, are we serious, bro? Like, y'all really don't see how obvious it is that these things are being, like, you guys are being triggered. And let me not say you guys, because I have to myself be very aware of these agendas, fam. A lot of times we be getting hyped up. Gillette got niggas hyped. You see Terry Crews again. Hey, I got on Terry Crews. I think it was my episode 2. Super Negro Terry Crews out there again in the Gillette commercial talking down on toxic masculinity. And I called it out exactly what it was. That man offended the homosexual community, the LGBT. Is it the Q yet? Did they get the Q yet? I think they got the Q. Let's go with the LGBTQ. They offended him. He offended the LGBTQ. And once he did that, it was a wrap, fam. Because he was like, bro, you try to put us out there? Okay, I'm going to lay low. And he was, the old boy was smiling like, all right, bro, I see you. You called me out. Cool. You thought you was going to Me Too me? All right, brother. I'm going to lay low. But you going to pay your penance. You going to pay. You going to pay what you owe. You going to be all on campaigns. You going to be, hey, fam. This man is talking about men have to hold each other accountable. Bro, men are holding each other accountable. Let's have an honest conversation right now. What happens to rapists and child predators? What happens to them when they go to jail? Where there is not regular rules, where jail is in the bare essential, let me not say bare essential, but the just, you know, it's the jungle. What happens to those men that commit those crimes and get sentenced to jail? Because honestly, the, like, if we're talking about guys that are escaping these charges, bro, let's get them all the way out of here, fam. I'm with it. Let's get these niggas out of here, bro. But I'm also not with co-signing with the agenda. And Terry Crews is definitely down with the agenda right now, bro. I am so disappointed. This dude is talking about toxic masculinity every chance he got. Mind you, this man got his dick grabbed by a homosexual man. Now look, I know we're in 2019 and everybody's trying to change the definition of masculinity, so y'all gonna try to finesse out of it, but fuck that. That's the, I'm gonna pull up right now the definition, the dictionary definition of masculinity, and we'll see if this matches the dude that grabbed Terry Crews' dick. And if it does not match the dude that grabbed Terry Crews' dick, then what are we really talking about then? Let's see. Masculine. Having qualities or appearance traditionally associated with men, especially strength and aggressiveness. Now look, as far as strength, I've seen this guy. Definitely not his definition. That's not his strong suit. He's not strong. This guy is, look, he's just not the most masculine person, fam. So this is not about toxic masculinity. We know for a fact that sexual predators come in all types, shapes, forms, sizes, genders, races, all that shit. So why are we focusing on toxic masculinity instead of the issue? Like, let's give you an example. Sexual abuse. We know that, unfortunately, from what came out of this R. Kelly situation, we found out about, honestly, unfortunately, a lot of boys. And I hate getting to the Olympics of who's struggle versus this struggle. Let's not get into that. But yes, a lot of boys are coming out like, shit, I was 11 years old when I first had my sexual experience. I was 10 years. We know personally a lot of dudes. I personally know a lot of dudes who have lost their virginity at a young age. Look, very embarrassing, fam. I was a late bloomer. I started my shit late. these niggas is 10, 11 years old. You telling me that's not gonna warp your mind on how you view sexuality and females and things like that by an older woman, you know, touching you? But that's not an issue though. I have a son. That's an issue. That's something I worry about. Just like I would worry about that when I have a daughter. God bless. You know, I don't understand why we're not trying to focus on the issues. Instead, we're trying to break down and turn this into gender politics and this versus that and that group versus this. Like, bruh, let's keep this on what it's supposed to be. That's why shout out to Tariq Nasheed for starting that Them First movement. Is it the Them Too or Them First? I'm lazy to look it up. But yeah, essentially he's calling out a lot of the hypocrisy that's left over this R. Kelly shit of how cats was, you know, 11, 12-year-old, 13-year-old. We had my boy Iggy Pop. Wrote a song talking about sleeping with this famous groupie that when she was 13 years old and he was like 23. Like, that's crazy. And that's just like, all right, and it is what it is. It's like, and it's funny because white folks got like, you got us. Oh, you guys know about Elvis? Oh, shoot. Wait a minute. Jerry Lee Lewis, you guys know about that? You got us, bro. Okay, we'll drop it. What's the next thing? Get at the masculinity. Hit him with the Gillette commercial. Drop it. You know what's funny though? Actually, I guess that could have been a Jedi mind trick, because essentially it was a lot of white dudes being, I know white cast was hot. The white dudes was looking like the damn devil in the damn show. They was grabbing maids' asses. I mean, bro, that's another thing too, fam. That's done, yes. But who got a maid today? And like, besides from Arnold Schwarzenegger, who got a maid that they're, you know, sexually assaulting and all that kind of shit like that? Like, come on. Even Arnold Schwarzenegger dropped a C with her, you know? So it came with benefits. She got that Terminator and she had a little baby Terminator. Shout out to her. But yeah, man. Honestly, this all started off from a rant about Derrick Jaxn. And honestly, I'm still pissed off about this Derrick Jaxn shit, because Derrick Jaxn is really just doing the ladies, specifically black women, a disservice, a major disservice. And slowly but surely, I feel like it's my job to undo the bad that Derrick Jaxn has done, undo the evil that he has done. So when Derrick Jaxn is saying, like, it don't matter if you 240 pounds and look like you could play the middle linebacker for the Chiefs, you still deserve a loyal, rich, six-pack man. Don't look, I'm not gonna fuck with you. Me, Derrick Jaxn? No. I'm not gonna fuck with you. But you deserve to be married. So what, you got 3 kids, 4 baby daddies? That doesn't matter. You deserve, because you are a queen. By virtue of you being a black woman, you deserve to meet this six-pack God black man who's gonna take away all your hurt, all your pain. He's gonna redeem all the things that you've done, all the mistakes. It's his job. That's what he's there for. He's supposed to fix every mistake. You don't have to even admit. You don't have to say I made a mistake. It's his job. He better know and get to fixing. Yeah, bro. Y'all wildin', man. This Sim culture, these Derrick Jaxn, these dudes pandering, it's not gonna work, bro. And I'm really blessed to be out the game completely and married. Because there's a lot of weirdo shit happening right now. It's a lot of no real connections. It's a lot of just loose sex, loose morals, diseases, mad babies, mad hurt, mad tears. It's just, yo, I'm not to laugh about it, because God forbid, you know, I hope I never, ever, ever have to be single again, obviously, but damn, it's looking like a battleground out there right now. Love is warfare in these streets right now, and Cass is running around here with no help, getting headshots out here. So, like, look, protect yourself at all times, fam. It's like a boxing match, bro. I know this is a very cliche, very, very cliche thing to say, but brothers and sisters, we got to protect ourselves at all times. And number one, let's stop lying to each other. That's why I wanted to create this show, because I'm just going to be honest. A lot of times in these Facebook and Instagram and Twitter back and forth, there's a lot of time for in between just dishonesty and deflection and bullshit. So I just want to say how I feel and get it out there. And if you don't like it and you don't listen to it, that's fine. But I got to do my part. I got to at least be honest and tell the truth as I see it. And, you know, my my truth is going to be different than a lot of people's truth, but a lot of people don't research no truth. So I'm going to trust my truth more than their truth, and I'm going to, as best as I can, try to present that to the world, because I'm telling people, I'm telling specifically black people, there is an agenda to have us beef. There's an agenda to have us have dysfunctional arguments, and I'm just going to expose that over time, and hopefully in a more comical and fun way, and continue giving out bars. But real shit though, Derrick Jaxn, my nigga, let me just end this off with this, bro. I knew Derrick Jaxn was a powerful man because this man is sitting here talking about love and marriage and all this shit like that, and then come to find out the man had a seed outside of his marriage, and then females still forgave him. They was just like, well, you know, he wore a sweater that said I still believe in marriage, so it's all good because he still believes in marriage. You know, he's talking shit to niggas who's knocking women up and not marrying them, but hey, he's like, bro, how? I don't get it. I mean, I don't understand. But look, that's it for tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I appreciate you guys for sticking with me through these entire rants and a whole bunch of shit talking. Please, please, I know somebody's gonna probably be offended, but it is what it is. It's gonna be worse, so you might as well just delete my shit now and take it off. All right, y'all. Well, I appreciate y'all. Y'all have a good night. Peace.
Cracking foes like a vase. You want the drama? We got the drama for you and your foes down. Whole lot of guns, whole lot of chopper, whole lot of smoke for them. Whole lot of motherfucking yellow tape. You don't want to smoke with them. That's about me. Y'all nigga from the street, straight up PD. Shoot the motherfucker straight in the fake cloak case. Nigga, that by me. Nigga, I'm so gutter with it. I'm slimy. Nigga, I get with it. I'm with this shit. You with this shit, nigga? I don't think you with this shit. Do you got that shit? Because I took that shit, nigga. That's some daily shit. Yeah. I'll Peter roll a nigga if I got to. Nigga, don't make me put this stick out, I might chop you. Nigga popped in like some bitches. Go and crush your head and nigga, you ain't gonna need no stitches.
Fuck a beat, I was tryna beat a case. But I ain't beat that case, bitch, I did the race. Beat it up, wear a nut, shorty face. Eli blast, cracking foes like a vase. Pop a nigga, then I go out my way. Do the dash, then I go out the way. Rob a nigga shoes, rob a nigga lace. Tryna see 100 bins in our face.